really like you, I say I don't. I really like to tell you but I won't. Gotta be careful, don't wanna say what I've been feeling if you're not feeling the same. I'm not good at reading between the lines, but I'm not sure you're leaving me.
Hawaiian rolls meet French toast in the breakfast of your dreams, and I really thought these were going to be too sweet, but they turned out perfect. They're super fluffy in the center, crispy on the edges, and super easy to make. In a bowl, whisk together half and half, eggs, vanilla extract, cinnamon, and a little bit of brown sugar. Then we'll take our Hawaiian rolls, and my favorite way to eat them is just smush them and have them plain. But we're obviously going to dip it into the batter, let any excess drip, and then fry it in a little bit of butter in a heated pan. Let them get golden on all edges just like this, and that's basically it. All that's left to do is enjoy with some powdered sugar and maple syrup on top.
Now that it's unofficially fall, you're going to be bombarded by tons of pumpkin recipes, and I think this is the one recipe that you have to make. It is incredibly moist, and if you've never had a brown butter cream cheese frosting, well, it's about to change your life. To a bowl, add white sugar, brown sugar, eggs, vegetable oil, pumpkin puree, and vanilla extract, and whisk until smooth. Then you'll add the jar ingredients, which is all-purpose flour, pumpkin spice, cinnamon, baking soda, baking powder, and salt. When you have a batter, transfer it to your loaf pan and pop in the oven to bake. Moving on to the frosting, we're going to brown our butter, let it solidify to room temperature, and then beat that with some cream cheese, powdered sugar, and vanilla extract. Once the cake has come out of the oven, let it cool for about an hour so that our frosting doesn't melt. Then we'll add a nice thin layer, because you don't want it too sweet, of the frosting on top, sprinkle with some pumpkin pie spice, slice, and that is basically it. It is just so soft and packed with so much pumpkin flavor. It is still really hot outside, but I'm already watching Gilmore Girls and my house smells like pumpkin spice baked goods, and so should yours. Now, these pumpkin cream cheese danishes are super easy to make, and they're basically kind of like a toaster strudel. You're gonna start by combining softened cream cheese, sugar, vanilla extract, and egg yolk for the first filling. For the second filling, you're gonna need pumpkin puree, brown sugar, pumpkin pie spice, an egg, and a little bit of sweetened condensed milk. Mix that together, and then we're gonna make our icing, which is just milk, powdered sugar, and a bit of vanilla extract. Then we'll roll out a puff pastry sheet to make it thinner, and then cut into 6 to 8 rectangles. Then make indentations of a smaller rectangle using a knife, brush with egg wash, add the cream cheese filling, then the pumpkin pie filling, add a little bit of sugar around the edges, and pop in the oven to bake until beautifully golden and crispy. Finish off with the glaze, and then enjoy!
Seems to hold me like you do. You're so wonderful. A star could never shine as bright as you. Thank you.
are you leaving me any signs? So could you say what's on your mind? If I said I want you, would you want me to? And would you really want me or just something new? Cause something's not.
Today we're making probably my favorite cookie recipe that I've made in a while, so here's how I made it. So compared to my OG recipe, I adjusted the brown sugar and added a little bit more because I wanted the center of the cookies to be a little bit more chewy. So here I'm just adding our sugars and butter together, and we're going to mix it for about 2 minutes until well combined. I also added an extra stick of butter to this recipe because I wanted the cookies to spread out a little bit more than my last recipe. But now that our butter and sugars are combined, we're going to add 2 eggs, one at a time, as well as vanilla extract and 2 tablespoons of milk. Mix until well combined, but make sure not to overmix your batter, and then we're going to add in all of our dry ingredients. I also added cinnamon into this recipe, but if you don't like cinnamon, don't add it. I just think cinnamon complements chocolate chip cookies extremely well. Now we're gonna add in 4 ounces of semi-sweet chocolate and 4 ounces of milk chocolate. If you don't like milk chocolate, use dark chocolate. And then I use a standard cookie scoop to scoop out the cookies. I also added extra chunks of chocolate on top of the cookie dough before I baked them, and then fresh out of the oven, added some flaky salt. And also an important tip, only bake one cookie the first time around, because once your cookie sheet is warm from the oven, the second batch usually comes out slightly different anyway, so that's usually how I avoid it. And you're done. Today we're making baked apple cider donuts, a very unintimidating recipe to bake, so here's how I made them. You want to start off by reducing 1.5 cups of apple cider down to 1/2 cup to 1/3 cup, anywhere between there is fine, on low to medium heat. Set it aside to cool, and we're going to get started on combining all of our wet ingredients. So your butter and sugars, mix, and then add your sour cream, 2 eggs, your vanilla extract, mix again, and then add in your reduced apple cider as well as regular apple cider that we didn't reduce, and then all of your dry ingredients. Fold everything together until well combined, and you're going to add it to your donut tray. Only fill it up about halfway, because if you fill it up more than that, you're going to be left with a mess in the oven, but bake at 350 for about 12 minutes, and they should look something like this. Now finally, allow them to cool until you're able to touch them without burning your hands. Brush them with some butter, coat them in cinnamon sugar, and you're done. Today we're making raspberry cheesecake with homemade whipped cream and raspberry jam. We're gonna begin with our crust, so add your graham crackers, salt, butter, and sugar into a food processor, and we're going to blend until it looks something like this. Pack down your crust in a 7-inch pan as well as up the sides, and we're going to bake at 350 for about 10 minutes. And now for our cheesecake, we're going to whisk our cream cheese until smooth, and then add our sugar, salt, as well as cornstarch, and whisk until smooth again. Scrape down your bowl as needed, and then we're going to add our sour cream and vanilla, whisk, and then we're going to add our eggs one at a time. Our crust should be slightly cooled by this point, so we're going to add our filling and bake at 350 for about 60 to 75 minutes in a water bath. Loosen the sides of your pan so we can prevent any other cracks from forming, and we're going to let it sit at room temperature for 2 hours. Then after 2 hours, we're going to pop it in the fridge and let it sit overnight. Trust me, it makes the biggest difference. The next morning, add your homemade whipped cream and jam, decorate however you'd like, and you're done.